Today I'm going to be teaching you how to fix an issue that stops players from playing Minecraft on the Windows 10 edition by continuously crashing at 37% whenever they load up their games. And to up the stakes even more, I'm going to be telling you, yes you, that this method will work guaranteed for each and every single viewer watching this video as long as you follow all my steps correctly. So let's get right into the video. Shalom, fellow Minecraft players. My name is, of course, Catmanjoe, or you can call me Joe or Joey, whatever you prefer. And today I'm going to be going over how to actually fix and stop the Minecraft Windows 10 Edition loading screen crash. If you haven't experienced this for yourself, let me quickly explain what the loading screen crash actually is. Whenever certain players experiencing this issue try to load up their Minecraft Windows 10 editions, unlike the normal Mojang loading screen normally loading up from 0 to 100%, then onto the main menu, what happens is the Mojang loading screen loads to 36% or sometimes 37%, then stops entirely, eventually either crashing or closing down the application. No matter if the person who is actually experiencing this uninstalls the game, then re-downloads it, or turns the computer on and off, it doesn't resolve the problem, resulting in players being entirely unable to play the game. The way I actually found out about this issue was due to it happening to me firsthand also, since I just bought a brand new PC and I just started downloading Minecraft, of course, onto it. And because I couldn't find any tutorials on YouTube, I decided to make my own because I found an actual fix that genuinely does work. So today, I'm going to be showing you guys the only guaranteed way to fix this issue 100%. So let's get right into the steps. Okay, so for step number one, what you're going to want to do is press the Windows key on your keyboard, or if you don't want to do that, go down to the bottom left of your screen and click the Windows search bar and simply type CMD or command prompt. Now for step number two, what you're going to want to do is click run as administrator, and you'll be prompted with a little message asking, do you want to allow this app to make changes to your device? Simply and quickly just select yes. Moving on to step number three, type the following or copy and paste it. I'll have all the steps and text form down below in the description along with these commands if you need them, so don't worry, alright? But yeah, you're going to want to type this, DISM space forward slash online space forward slash get dash compatibilities. Again, this will be down below in the actual description. I would probably recommend either reading it for yourself in the description or just copy and pasting it from the description itself, it's much easier. Okay, so going on to step number four, if you enter the first command correctly, then hit enter on your keyboard, you should see this exact same thing right here. A huge list of things saying compatibility identity, then something else beside it, of course, some random other thing, all right? What we're looking for is one specific line that says compatibility identity, media.media feature pack, tittle 0.0.1.0. The entire list that you're going to be looking at is arranged in alphabetical order, so you should be able to find it quite easily, all right? But when you find media.media feature pack, again, just don't do anything, just look at it and just wait for step number five, okay? Now that you've located compatibility identity media.media feature pack, for step number five, you should from here be able to see what the state is, all right? If it says not installed right beside the word state, then that's our problem here. You are missing some media dependencies that are required to run the game, but don't worry, we're about to fix that really easily right now. So for step number six, run the install command for media.media feature pack. To do this, just type out like before or copy and paste, as I've said already, the following message. DISM space forward slash online space forward slash add dash compatibility space forward slash compatibility name the two dots, I don't know what you call that, media.media feature pack, tittle 0.0.1.0. Then press enter. Once you've done that, from here you'll see a little bar with a percentage meaning it's downloading, so just wait until it completes, you know, 100% fully. Once you see 100%, then finally type Y into the command line and your PC will restart. Once it's restarted, simply load up your Minecraft and boom, I can't click my fingers, and boom, you'll be able to play once again on your Minecraft. It's that easy. And yeah, everybody, that is the end of this video. I want to real quick give credit to the actual Reddit user, TheChebert, I think that's how you say it, TheChebert, I'm not sure how you meant to say his name, for discovering this method and sharing it with the community. His Reddit will be linked down below, of course. And I want to say real quick, thank you, mysterious viewer, for watching. I really hope you enjoyed this tutorial or it helped you out in some way, shape or form, or even, you know, you learned something new from it. I don't know, that's what's so important, isn't it? And you know, before you go, I mean, I wouldn't mind if you could drop a like, a comment, and a share on this video. It would really be pretty cool. And you know, maybe also subscribe. I'm just saying, you know, I'm trying to reach 69,420 subs before OnlyFans doesn't allow nudity, so I can reward my viewers, or my gorgeous viewers, with some, yeah, I'm gonna stop here before I get demonetized. Bye.